Hi everyone. Welcome to a live class with Teacher Class. Today we have someone very special with us who's going to take us through a lot of assessment and quizzing tools, Sumedha ma'am. And we're just waiting for more participants to join the call. But in the meanwhile, please feel free to say hello in the chat. In the chat room and introduce yourself, your name, which school you're from, which city you come from, and what you want to take away from this session. Welcome everyone. If you can't hear, that means you've not joined via audio. I'm requesting you to please click join via audio.
Very password me here.
Hello, ma'am. Good afternoon.
Good afternoon, ma'am. I'm requesting you all to put yourself on mute. We're going live on YouTube. So request all participants to mute themselves.
Good afternoon, ma'am.
Good afternoon. Requesting all participants to please do not unmute yourself. We're live. Please introduce and say hello via the chat.
Hello, ma'am. I'm with the other.
Good afternoon, ma'am.
Requesting all participants to please mute themselves. Hi, I would request all participants to keep themselves on mute and put off their videos. We're doing this to preserve our internet speed. If you cannot hear us, then please click join via audio and you should be able to hear us. Welcome to our live class with Sumedha Sodhi, ma'am. She's going to be taking us through 5 unique quizzing apps that we can use to check and understand how much our students have learned. Sumedha ma'am is an expert facilitator in these 5 tools. She's run many workshops in different platforms such as the Firki platform, Teachers Help Teachers, and many more. So we're really pleased and honored to have her here teaching all of us how to use these 5 amazing quizzing tools. Before we get started with this session, I want to just introduce Teacher Class or what we do at Teacher Class with you. So I'm going to quickly show you a small video. All right. So Teacher Class is a platform that is India's only platform where teachers can discover educational tools. It's essentially made for teachers by teachers, and you can access teaching tools here, video tutorials, and you can also learn with other teachers through our live classes. So we have a tool repository. If you go to our website, that is www.teacherclass.org, you will be able to find a tool repository right on top where you can find a list of curated tools for teachers. You can explore the different features of these tools and requirements that you need to have to access these tools with a simple click of a button. You can also sign up for live classes on our homepage where you can learn about different tools that you need and that you have chosen to use in your classroom. Uh, We have a register with us button. So in case you would like to hear about, you know, the new tools that we've added to our tool repository, new videos or live classes, etc., register with us today by clicking that button. So here's where you can register for a live class. You can watch our in-demand tool tutorials, and you can discover tools for educators. So we're going to share 5 simple steps in which you can become a super teacher. Step 1, join a community of educators. I will be sharing a link with you shortly. Request you to register on that link and you will join a growing community of now 5,000 educators. You can browse through our 30 curated tools in the tool repository and find access to tools such as Gmail, Google Classroom, and many more, the Deeksha app, Edpuzzle, etc. And you can learn about the different features of these tools. We also offer offline paid tools, so you can learn about offline paid tools as well. And you can actually explore your need-specific tools in the categories that we've created on the website. So if we go into Google Classroom, you'll actually be able to see the languages it's available in, what you need or what kind of internet connectivity you need, the important features and benefits. Step number 3 is access our 150 videos in English and Hindi on the different tools that we have on our tool repository. You can subscribe on our YouTube channel and get access to these videos. So our YouTube channel, just search for Teacher Class Foundation and it'll be one of the top hits and you will find our YouTube channel. So click the subscribe button and join our community. The last is sign for a free class. So I have already shared with you the schedule for our free class, but we will also put it up on our website for next week. And you can register for a class of your choice. And lastly, share this with share the work that we're doing with other teachers, because as we know, it's extremely important for us as educators to share resources with other teachers. All right. I'm just going to pause my share. Great. All right. So I'm going to, before, you know, Sumedha ma'am starts with the session, I am going to quickly set a few ground rules. Firstly, requesting all participants to put their videos off and do not unmute yourself, right? Secondly, if you have any questions at any point of time, please use our chat window to, ask your questions. We'll be sharing links. Once I stop talking and Sumedha ma'am takes over, I will share all the links that I spoke about with you on the chat window. So please be patient. Again, requesting all participants to put their videos off. I'm going to quickly share my screen and show you, what our plan is for this session. So in today's session, we're going to look at online tools to assess learning. And if anyone is having any difficulty hearing what we're saying, please click the join via audio button, right? Both will be available on the bottom left-hand side of your devices, whichever device that you're using. What you will need, we will need pen and paper, laptop or phone to take notes. Please save your links that we share with you in chat. For homework, so you can access the resources that we're sharing with you at a later point. Stay engaged, ask questions, answer questions, and respect each other. So please use the chat. I would ask everyone to resist from annotating. So please do not annotate on our screen or draw anything on our screen. Requesting again participants to participate a lot in our live Q&A sessions and polls so that we can design a good experience for all of you. A few expectations. We're expecting all participants to mute themselves so that everyone can hear what Sumedha ma'am has to share. Keep your video off. I can still see some participants who have left their video on, requesting all participants to shut down their video. Ask your questions through chat only, right? And we will pause in every segment to answer your questions. So please have patience. You can put all of your questions in our comment section and we will answer it whenever Sumedha ma'am takes a pause. All right. Before any other delay, I'm going to launch our first quiz or our first poll with you and requesting all participants to participate in this poll. So the question here is, how comfortable are you using online assessment tools such as Kahoot, Quizzes, Quizlet, and Quizalese to assess learning? Please be as honest as possible so that we can understand your comfort level and design this learning experience for you. Requesting all participants to participate in this quiz so that we can design a great learning experience for you. All right, so I'm going to end the poll and we're going to share the results. As you can see, most participants are, not very comfortable with online quizzing tools. So this is a great introductory session to that. I hope you will be able to learn about at least 5 new quizzing apps and tools and have a really fruitful session with Sumedha ma'am. All right. I'm going to also launch a pre-session survey that will help all of us understand or build a shared understanding of why we want to use digital tools for online assessments and if we are using these tools. All right, so there are 3 questions requesting all teachers to participate. So the first question is, do you use digital tools for online assessment? You can simply select yes or no. The second question is, how comfortable are you using online tools for teaching and assessment of your learners, right? And then the third question is, name the digital tools you would love to learn through our live classes. So we've kind of clubbed it into categories and we just want to learn from you. What are your needs and how comfortable are you with online tools? This will help us design better sessions in the future. So requesting all of you to participate. quickly, we're going to keep this poll open for another 10 seconds. So whoever has missed this question, please put in your answer so that your voices get accounted for, and you know what you want to learn. We really source of you know content and facilitators for your requirements. Great. I'm going to end poll, and our participants can all have a look at the results. Awesome. So Medha ma'am, you can take it over from here and start with your session.
Okay. Thank you so much, ma'am. Good evening, all the participants, and thank you, teacher class. I am overwhelmed with the kind of welcome and the opportunity that has been given to me. And it is simply awesome to see the work which you are doing to empower the educators who are engaged in preparing the 21st century learners. It's really glad to be a part of your platform, ma'am. So let me just share my screen and start our presentation. Sonia ma'am, can you please confirm if my screen is visible?
Ma'am, your screen is visible.
Okay. So let me start my presentation. Technology has enabled students and teachers to leverage the various forms of formative assessment using various EdTech tools. Digital technology creates an environment where students are engaged and excited about learning. This engagement also trickles over to the assessment process as well as to the process where students have to leap at the opportunity to use a digital tool to showcase the skills which they have mastered or the concepts which they are learning. It is rightly quoted by a very famous personality, Ms. Suzanne Mann, that the use of online assessment tools is giving teachers a more fine-grained understanding of what they are learning and how the individual student skills are assisting them to determine the necessary steps to enable them to achieve their own learning goals. We are able to see more effective differentiation in the virtual classrooms as a result of using these EdTech tools. So today's session is going to talk about three main things. What is the role of assessment? Why we should use online assessments or digital assessments, but now in this situation, we don't have any other alternative. Due to pandemic situation, the schools have adopted a new normal system where we have to take the digital assessment to see how much the learning is taking place. So the five tools we are going to explore today, first we are going to learn about them in the theoretical way, then we are going to take on the hands-on practice with these digital tools. First, I would like to talk about the role of assessments here. Assessments are the windows and not the doors. Let us treat them as opportunities into what students are doing and not as a milestone they need to cross. Different types of assessment that we have can be grouped as diagnostic assessments, the formative assessments, and the summative assessments. talking about the diagnostic assessments first. These assessments are the assessments in which we are assessing the student to know what the child already knows, what is the previous knowledge assumed before we actually introduce a new skill or knowledge to the student. These are useful for identifying the weaknesses and strengths of a student. Then talking about the formative assessments, it evaluates the student acquisition of the skill or knowledge being taught at the periodic intervals. So if you are taking a small kind of assessment after every chapter or the basic top subtopic, that will be regarded as a formative assessment. It is useful for identifying the various areas for planning a remediation, the proficiency, and providing adequate feedback to the child. Now, talking about the summative assessments. Summative assessment evaluates the student performance for assessing a specific skill or knowledge at the end of an instructional period. These are very useful for identifying the areas for spiral review, conferencing with the students about the goals, and measuring the overall student progress. So now let us see that why these online assessments are beneficial for us, because of the simple reason that these assessments enriches the experience and make the learning interactive. The digital tools which I am going to explore with the teacher community today, they give instant diagnostic feedback to the child. The data collection and analytical reasoning, which is required for every teacher to study that what specific measures are required to improve the learning, becomes easier with these tools. Also, these tools provide a platform where the child have the option of self-directed learning. And it helps in building the competency skills which are required for a 21st century learner, like problem solving, critical thinking, creativity, and also instill in them a flair for the decision making. Also, another benefit of using these tools is they all provide a platform where you have both the facilities of synchronous learning and asynchronous learning. So talking about synchronous learning, it's the learning which is taking when the child is present in front of us, and the learning which is taking place when the child is doing the work later, not in the classroom, in the presence of teacher. That is the asynchronous mode of learning. So the child has the option of learning on his own self-paced mode. So if you are excited about today's session and you are prepared, you are ready to rock, so please type in the chat box, let the learning begin. And let me see how enthusiastic the teachers are to learn about the new tech tools. Please write in the chat box, let the learning begin. And let me see your enthusiasm about learning the EdTech tools. Great. So I can see teachers are quite excited about learning about the 21st century tools. And I'm going to assure you that if you are going to use these tools in your platform, in your daily learning experience, you are definitely going to rock. So let us go and explore the first tool. And the first tool we are going to explore is the Kahoot, which is a game-based classroom response system. Now, why we should use this tool? We have to make our students excited about learning. And that is why we have to use this tool called Kahoot, where students do not need to set up their accounts. It is easy to access. It is a user-friendly tool. And there are multiple ways to play and use Kahoot. Most of the activities that you can plan with this particular tool can be cross-curricular or interdisciplinary. It caters to different learning styles of the learners as per their multiple intelligence. And also, this is a free to use tool. Now, first, I'm going to tell you that how you can access this tool. So once you go to your Google, you just have to create a sign in for your particular terms and condition as per the information required by the app and register yourself. So first you have to do is you have to type in the address kahoot.com, and I will show you that in the demo session after going through the steps. Once you log in, so you will be asked, you will be given a template that you can create your own quizzes with the platform. Some basic information about the quiz will be required to fill it. Once you put in the basic information about the quiz you are going to create, you will be given the choice of questions that you want to frame, whether you want to frame multiple choice questions or you want to frame the true-false question. And if you take the paid version, you will be given more choices of question to be created. And once your quiz is ready, you can play a live quiz or an assessment, formative assessment with your students while you are teaching them in the virtual classroom. Or if you want to do it later and you want that it should be student-based, so the student can play it later as per his own will or comfort. And for playing the quiz, we need to share the game pin which the teacher is going to create for the child so that the child can take the quiz which is planned by the teacher. So let us go to the website and take a hands-on experience for this particular platform, which is called Kahoot. So in case you can do it simultaneously with us, it will be really great. So first I will go to Google and I will type there the email address kahoot.com. So once I log into this website, kahoot.com, it will ask me that if you are already existing user, you have to log in. And if I do not have an account here, I have to sign up. So let me take you to the sign up option. And if you don't have an account, it is going to ask you a few questions that whether you are a teacher or you want to create an account as a student, or is it your personal account or professional account. Since we are maximum teachers here in the session today, so let us go to the option teacher. And once I select the teacher option, it is going to ask me that describe your workplace. So I work in a school as a teacher. Accordingly, I am choosing the option school. Now it is giving me an option to create an account either using a new email ID, or I can use my already existing Google ID or Microsoft ID. So for example, if I wish to make an account with the ID, so I'm using this ID of teacher class 123@gmail.com, and it will ask me to mention the password also. So I am taking a password. So according to your choice, you can put a password which is easy to remember so that later on you don't forget the password, and click on sign up. So once I sign in, this page will open up, which is going to show me the different plans that the Kahoot platform offers. So the basic plan, which is free for the teachers, is given over here. If I want to pay and use the pro program, I have to pay $3 per month. And if I want to use the premium platform, then there is a different plan. So I'm using the platform free. So I will click here, continue for free. So once I come here, it asked me further information. So I have to fill in my details. My username is teacher class. I have to mention my country. And school name is also required. So I'm going to enter my school name. And I have to save and continue. So once I complete all the steps, this is the page where I will land in. And this page gives me the option to create my own quiz for my learners. So let us together create a quiz. So on the top, you can see this white color tab. I have to go and click here, create. So it is asking me, what do you want to create? So I will say, I want to create a Kahoot for my learners. So it is going to give me a platform where I can mention the questions for my learners. So let us make a quiz here together. Here I have to mention the Kahoot title. So I'm going to make a quiz on resources. I can give a description over here. It is asking me, where do you want to save it? So there is a domain called My Kahoots in which all the quizzes which you are making are going to be saved. Do you want to put any lobby video for your students? First, maybe you want them to watch some YouTube video and then proceed to the quiz. So it is your choice if you want to put it. Then you also have an option of putting a cover image. So I can change it. I can use the image library, which is given by Kahoot. So there are many images which are given by Kahoot. So I can use those images. And once I use the image, it is asking me which language your quiz is in. So I can select the language from here, whatever language I want to make the quiz in. So there are different Indian languages also which can be used. There is, I can see Malay, Marathi, and many foreign languages are also there. Hindi is also there. Bangla is also there. So there are multiple languages which can be used to make the quiz. Now there is another option that whether you want this quiz to be visible by you or all the teachers who are on Kahoot platform. So if you want your quiz to be private, you can click on only you. And if you want to put any lobby music for your learners while playing the quiz, they will also get an experience of listening to the music if you allow them. And once all the information is put, you can click on done. And you are ready to type your first question. So my first question here is, what are resources? So the other thing I have to set is the time limit for my learners. I want my learners to answer this question in 5 seconds, 10 seconds, 20 seconds. Accordingly, I can set the timer. Also, this is the question where only one single select is required or multiple select is required is the option given by the platform. So here you can see there are 4 multiple choice options that I can put in for my learners. For example, I am putting 1 or 2 questions to see how you have to frame the quiz. So the first option I am writing, everything we need to satisfy our needs, our resources, or simply I can read, write resources are the substances. Then here I can mention resources are the materials. And here I can write resources are the objects. So now I have to tell to the platform which out of the 4 is the correct answer. I have to put a tick mark over here. And there is also an option for every question. I can put an image or a YouTube video link to make the quiz interactive and engaging for my learners. I can design an assessment where my child will get the clue from the image. I can upload my own images, which are on my desktop. I can use the image library, which is the images which are given free by this platform, or I can search for a appropriate YouTube link. For example, if I want to put a YouTube link, I will click here. It will take me to a platform asking whether you want to paste any YouTube link or you want to find a video on YouTube. So for example, I want to find a video on YouTube. So I can go to YouTube and I can search for an appropriate video for chapter resources class 10th. And maybe I like this video by Siksha House.
Hey, koi foundation
jo use. So I can simply copy paste the link from here. And paste the link over here. Once I paste the link, I can add it. So it gives the option to my learner to first watch the video and then answer the question. So this is how I want to make my assessment. Once my first question is set, I can move on to this tab, add question, and put in the another question. So two kind of questions are free. In the free version, two types of questions are there. Either you can form a multiple choice question or a true or false question. So second question maybe I want to use is a true false type question. So then I will type my second question over here. And my second question is, natural resources are unlimited in nature. True or false? So this answer is false. Every natural resource is not unlimited. We have to use them carefully. And I can set the timer 10 seconds. I can choose an image from the library. So let me see. These are the free images which I can explore on different themes. So let me choose this image. And now once my questions are set, similarly, there is also a very good option of a question bank. Two questions I have created. Now let me use the question bank by Kahoot and search the questions which are there on this particular theme resources. And let me see. So I can see there are a lot of questions which other teachers have made in other Kahoot. So there is a question on human resources. If I like this question, I can simply click on add and it will be automatically added to my quiz. I can browse through all the questions. So here is a question, renewable resources are resources that. So yes, this gels my quiz. I can simply add it. I can browse. So you can see there are so many questions which are given by the platform. So I need not spend much time on creating a quiz. It will hardly take 10 minutes to make a quiz. It is as simple as making a cup of tea. It is not going to take much time. It is just we have a little hitch in creating something new. That was the first time when I also felt that no, it will be very difficult. But once I started using, I realized that is all the more easy, just like teaching from any technological friendly tool which we are already using in the classroom. Once my five questions are set, and I can simply click on done button. I don't know, my screen is stuck. Let me just share my screen again with everyone. Yes. So once I click on done button, my quiz is ready. And once my quiz is ready, It comes under a tab called My Kahoots. And I have to just simply open it up. And there are two options that I have to play this quiz with my learners. If I want to edit this quiz, I can edit it. If I want to add a few more questions or I want to do any corrections, I can use this tab. I can share the link of this quiz with my teacher colleagues, with my friends, to use this quiz in their classroom. These three buttons will give you more options of duplicating the quiz, renaming the quiz, previewing the quiz, or there is an option of play. So once I click on play, it gives me two options. Whether you want to teach the quiz live with your classroom, you are teaching a live classroom. I think somebody is trying to share the screen. Mr. Bhupender, may I please request to stop the screen sharing? Thank you so much. Yeah, so let us continue. So teaching the classroom will require that I can use this particular platform for teaching in my virtual classroom live. And assigning the quiz means I have to give this quiz to my learners to do it later as a homework or as an assignment. So if I want to teach it live, I will click on the button teach. So it will ask me a few more questions. Do you want to play it in a classic mode where every learner is having a single device, or you want to play it as a team? Since in the virtual classroom, all children are there at their home and they cannot be clubbed into team mode by me. It can only be done in the classroom situation. I have to take this classic option. And as I click classic option, my game is ready to be played. So it is showing an option. There is an option just saying that tell your learners to go to a website, kahoot.it. And once my learners go to the website called kahoot.it, they simply have to put this game code in the website 649 and 797. And we all will be able to play a live quiz with our children. So I have designed one live quiz for all of you. Let me take you to that quiz and let me show you how you can play that quiz, a live quiz with your students. Some of you have already started joining. I request you to please wait. That was just a demo to show you that how you can create a quiz. But I have made one quiz using my own Kahoot account for all of you to give you an amazing experience of playing the quiz, that how, what kind of encouragement and fun-filled way it is going to give you to your particular kids. So let me take you to that particular platform. And I request all of you to please log in to a website called kahoot.it to participate in the quiz right now along with me. Please open a website called kahoot.it. So I have prepared this quiz for all of you on the topic lockdown. This is a quiz on lockdown, since we all are experiencing this, and it was quite a learning experience for each one of us in our own fields. So let us participate in this quiz and enjoy it. So I request all of you to kindly go to a website called kahoot.it and enter the game pin, which is 386146. And all of you will be visible on my screen. Kindly go to a website called kahoot.it and please enter the game pin 386146. Yes, very good. Great. I'm so amazed to see. Already there are almost 30 players in the game. Excellent. I'm so happy to see your enthusiasm. You are definitely going to be great and tech-ready teachers who are going to rock this world. Great. I have 60 players. Awesome. So the rule of the game is the question is going to be displayed on my screen. The options are also going to be displayed on my screen. On your screen, only the four colors will be shown. So you have to read the question from my screen. You have to read the multiple options, the answer options from my screen, and choose the correct color code and click on that color code. On your screen, the question will not be displayed. I'm repeating again, the question is going to be displayed on the teacher's screen along with the options. You just need to click the correct color code and participate in the quiz. And at the end of the quiz, the winner is going to be announced today. So, wow, great. I have 94 players with me. Awesome. So let me just start the quiz. Others can join in. So once I click on this start button, the quiz will start on your screen also. So the first question is on my screen. What was the first task given by the Prime Minister Modi to pay respect to the front line warriors during lockdown? And the timer is set to 10 seconds. So 31 people have given the correct answer. Awesome. Great. Now let us move on to the next question and let me see the scoreboard. So someone by the name of RD is leading the quiz. Congratulations. The second question is on my screen is, Janta curfew was observed on 22nd March. Is this true or false? Awesome. I can see so many people are excited to give the answer. And 3, 2, 1 and go. So 62 people have given the correct answer. And yes, this answer is true. The next question on my screen. So Mr. RD or Miss RD is leading again in the quiz. The third question on my screen is, on which date PM Modi requested to light the diyas, torches and flashlights? I request the people who are doing annotations on the screen to please refrain from this. As teachers, we should be wise enough. If we will only do the such thing, so what our learners are going to do, you can experience. You are not small kids. Thank you. So now the next question. So now the leading person in the quiz is 80. Next question on the screen is, how did Modi ji define Corona in his address to the nation? Great. Wow, I can see 40 people have given the answer correctly. And let us see the scoreboard. So 80 is leading with 3942 points. Awesome. The next question. In which three zones entire nation has been divided? Great. 42 answers. Awesome. The time is running. Quickly. 4, 3, 2, 1 and go. So 60 people have given the right answer, that is green, red and orange. And let us see now, Miss Neeta is leading in the quiz with 5100 points. And the next question is, Lockdown 2 was announced on 16th April. Is this true or false? Great. I'm so enthusiastic to see the kind of answers I'm getting. All the participants are participating enthusiastically. Great. So many people are answering the correct answers. This itself is a testimony that how much you are aware about your surroundings. And the next question is, which phase is associated with lockdown 4.0? You have to identify the dates. And zero. Yes, let me see. So 34 people were able to guess it right. Now let me see. Now again, 80 is leading in the quiz. And the next question is, on 26th March, Finance Minister of India announced rupees 1,70 crore package. Is this true or false? Awesome. So 39 people have given the correct answers. Now the next question on my screen is, following lockdown in India, what is now visible from the city of Jalandhar due to the drop in air pollution? Excellent. Let me see how many people have given the right answer. So 47 people have given the right answer. And now the last question for today. The city, this city given in the picture here, is one of the cities on the lockdown in India. Which city is it? And I hope most of you belong to this city only. Great. So let me see. 61 people have given the correct answer. Now, let us set the podium for the winners and congratulate them. So the third position goes to Miss Neeta. The second position goes to PSV. And the first position goes to Mr. or Miss AT. Congratulations, all of you. And the runner-up are Amitized and PS. So you have yourself seen that how this platform is a great one to give a gamified experience to your students to play the quiz. This platform is going to make learning a really wonderful experience for your learners. And in case you don't have enough time to prepare the quiz, you can use the question bank, and you can also use the quizzes which are developed by teacher around the world by going to this tab, Discover. So once you go to the Discover option, there are multiple quizzes which are being developed by teachers across the world on different topics. I'm scrolling down to show you the quizzes. You can double click on any quiz. For example, if I want to use this solar system quiz, I will double click here and I will use this quiz in the same manner like I have done right now, just playing the quiz either in the synchronous mode or in the asynchronous mode with my learners. So similarly, if you want to download the reports of the quizzes that you have played with your students, you can go to the report tab on the top and you can see the reports of all the quizzes that you have played or your learners have played. So just now I have played a quiz on lockdown with all of you. So I will just show you what kind of report it is going to give me. So it is showing me the number of players, It is showing me how much people were able to give the correct answers. It is showing me who are the people who need little help, who were not able to finish the quiz, how many questions were in the difficult category. I can view the podium, the winners again. I can see how much time it took for my players to play the quiz. So all this kind of reports are given to you by the system itself, and it is all saved in the cloud. You can also see the feedback. If I received any feedback from any student for this quiz, I can see other report options that I have. I can download this report. I can print this report. I can view other kind of reports which it is giving me for to make my learner's experience better. So that is why Kahoot comes with own gamified experience for the students, and you are definitely going to love this platform if you are going to take a quiz or an assessment with your learners. So I hope all of you enjoyed and all of you loved this tool, and definitely you are going to make your own quizzes also and use the discovery tab also for taking the learning assessments of your own kids. So if you are excited about learning further about the next tool, and I want to see your enthusiasm, please type in the chat box, bring it on. Or in the short, you can also write BIO, bio. And let me see how enthusiastic my teachers are for learning the next tool, that is Quizlet.
Ma'am, before we go into the next tool, there are lots of questions that participants have. So yes, maybe you could spend about 5 minutes answering those questions.
Yes, ma'am. Sure. Definitely.
Great. So one of the questions that many people asked is, do students need to have two devices to be able to do this quiz while, they can see the teacher's screen?
No, the students need not have two devices, because once you are putting up the question there on your particular screen and the student is using his or her mobile phone or laptop or desktop, so the screen can be minimized. You can minimize the screen. The way I am doing, first I was showing you the PPT, then I minimized it and I show you the questions on my screen using Kahoot. So the same way the child can also see that.
Okay. Yeah. And ma'am, another question that people were asking was this is only for synchronous quizzing, right? That means you're taking a live class and you display or you share your screen that has the questions and the students have to answer at that time, right? Mm-hmm. So it's at the same time, like in a live class. But many were asking about the asynchronous form of quizzes on Kahoot. So if you could give a brief explanation, that would help the participants.
Yeah, sure. I will just show you that how you can assign the tasks to your learners, which can be played later on. You need not, maybe you don't have enough time or your learners do not have the devices with them. So what you can do is, you can assign the quiz to be played later on. So let me show you. So you can go to the website that we accessed, kahoot.com. And once you are logged in with your username, so for example, I want to play, assign this quiz that we have made on resources. So instead of choosing the teach option, I have to go to the assign option. I think I explained this while doing it. You have to click on assign option. And it is asking me that when do you want to assign this quiz? So the player should complete it before I can give the date to my children, that I want all of you to finish this quiz by 16 July 12 p.m. The question timer is on, and I can also switch on the option which is random answer order. I also give them the option where they can create a nickname for them if they don't want to reveal their identity. But if I want to know their names, I should remain it off. And I have to click on the create button. So once I click on the create button, so this quiz is created where I can copy the URL. The link can be copied and it can be pasted in the either in the WhatsApp group or in the email that you are going to send the, to the children, or in the Teams chat or in the Zoom chat window. Wherever you want to put this link, you can put it in the Google Classroom, you can put it in the Teams, you can put it on Facebook, Twitter, OneDrive or share option. So anywhere you can put this link for the players, and the child will be able to take up the quiz later on according to his comfort level whenever the device is available. And once all your children have done the quiz, so you can also check the report of the quiz that how many students have done. So right now it is going to show you what is the deadline, or whether you want to end this quiz, you want to play this challenge yourself first to see whether the questions are fine or is there any editing required in the question. So this is how you can play the quiz in the asynchronous mode with your learners. Is it clear?
Yes, ma'am. I think that's very clear. I think someone also mentioned that there is a polling feature, and then I think Namrata ma'am asked that question, and Zainab ma'am answered saying that the poll is not available for free account. It's only part of the paid account. Correct?
Yes, correct.
Okay. And is there a way that teachers can import questions from other file formats into
Kahoot? Yes, ma'am. If you already have questions which are typed in the Word document, you can simply copy paste the questions from there in the template.
Okay. And ma'am, how many questions can we add at one time?
It depends on you. 50, 100 questions, as many you want to make. There is no limitation.
There's no
given by the app that only these much questions are there in the free version. As many questions, and you can see here the maximum number of players who can play the quiz with this particular link are 100. For next set of 100 players, you have to make another link. So one link can be used by 100 players.
Okay, that's very helpful, ma'am.
Yes.
And someone's asking, especially I think math teachers will be curious, how to type mathematical equations or questions in a quiz.
Yeah. So, ma'am, in this platform, we do not have the option of mathematical equations. But my suggestion is that if you have the images of those questions, so you can upload those images from your desktop using the upload image option.
Okay.
Yeah,
all right.
That can be done. But we are going to use the other tools in which maths equations can be typed.
Right. And ma'am, some participants weren't able to see the options. Could you, like the answer options, could you throw some light into why they weren't able to see either the question or the answer options?
So Sonia ma'am, I told it in the beginning only that the question and the options are going to be displayed on the screen of the teacher, not on the screen of the participants. The participants are only going to see the colors, and they have to identify the correct option from those four colors which are reflecting. This is the feature which they have in the live quizzing session. But if you are going to give the link to the learners, then that problem will not come. The question as well as options will be visible on the screen.
Okay.
But only in the live quiz option, there is a this kind of feature which the app offers. The question will be visible only on the teacher's screen.
Okay, understood. Yeah. All right. And I think one thing, because I saw many teachers asking how students will see the screen. So one thing teachers, we need to be really mindful of is that this Kahoot form, right, like this, the synchronous version, right, or the live class version of the quiz that we did, we, Sumedha ma'am was sharing her screen, right? That's how you as participants were able to see the pin, right? So Similarly, when the quiz starts, the students are required to read the question from your screen because you will have to share your Kahoot screen. And all the students will be able to see once they go on to Kahoot.it is the options. So they're all colorful options. There'll be four or five options. And they have to select the right answer per what they can see on the shared screen.
And also, I would like to add that this Kahoot is available on Play Store. So all the students who are using mobile devices and they do not have laptops or desktop, so the teacher can tell the students in advance to download the app from the Play Store. And while the class is going, you just have to share the game pin and the child will be able to play the game. If you don't want to take up the synchronous mode where you are sharing your screen, so you can simply give this link to the learner with the game pin and the child will be able to play the game on his or her device. So this is awesome. Another option. You can download all the apps which I am going to talk about today from Play Store. So they are mobile friendly apps.
Great. Great. Yeah. All right. I think that's it for questions. We can go to the next tool. We may not have time to cover all five tools, ma'am. So I may interrupt. And we could do part two of this session next week. Okay. But let's play it by ear.
Yeah, sure. Thank you so much, ma'am. So let me take you to the another platform, which is called Quizlet. So if you remember, there were days when as teachers, we were asked to prepare the flashcards for our learners. And we always used to think that it is a very tedious task to draw something on one side and then write the definition on the other side, then make it colorful, make it creative, and then use it in the classroom. But this platform called Quizlet, it is a very simple tool for learning anything. And it is a flashcard tool, which also gives a gaming experience to the students. So what is the benefit of using this tool is that it engages the learner into a lot of study activities. There is an option of playing a live quiz the way that we have done in the Kahoot. You can use the material which is created by other teachers across the world. You can create your own customized material, set up the classes like you do in the Google Classroom and track the student progress. And once you are able to sign in, you can use the features which comes with the free version. Students simply love this. They choose what works best because there are plethora of options given to the children to play the flashcards in their own way. If they want to play it as a learn challenge, they can take up as a learn challenge. If they want to learn in the form of a flashcard, they can use it that way. If they are more of writing people, they are good writers, they can take the write challenge, they can take the spell challenge. Your entire quiz will be created in converted into a practice test by the software itself. You can do matching exercises and you can also do the animated gaming experience exercises with this platform.
Ma'am, I think your screen is not visible. So I'm just going to share my screen so that the participants can see your presentation. All right?
Sure, ma'am. Sure.
Can everyone see my screen?
Yeah, yes, ma'am.
All right.
Thank you so much. So once your quiz is set, you can easily convert the particular quiz into different kind of test for your learners. So next slide, ma'am. So how you can create your own customized material in the same way, just like you have seen in the Kahoot, we have created our question. You can import your material from a Word file, Excel file, or a Google document. You can do the editing whenever it is required. You can label the diagram. You can select a language for each kind of quiz you are going to set. So it is a very friendly tool which gives you the platform to create quiz for diverse learners which are belonging to different language diversity. Next, ma'am. You can also use the quizzes created by other teachers. So there are over 250 million sets on thousands of topics that have already been created by the other teachers and students, and they are absolutely free to use. It is all available in the free version, which can be easily utilized. Next. Also, there is an option of playing a live quiz, which helps in building the soft skills among the children. While in the classroom situation, when we are physically present, we can play the collaborative game also by putting them into teams. But due to the limitation of the lockdown, we can only play the game in a single mode right now and give the experience of the quiz to the children. Next, ma'am. So let us start with this demo, ma'am. Can I just start sharing my screen?
Yes, ma'am.
To have a demo session?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. So let me take you to this platform. I request all the teachers to please open the website called quizlet.com. Is my screen visible now?
Yes, ma'am. It's slightly pixelated.
Okay. So you just have to go to the website called quizlet.com and click on the login. It is again asking me a question, because if I am a first time user, I have to make an account over here. So either I can use my Gmail ID or my Facebook ID, or I can create a new username or password. So let me make a new account here. So I'm using the ID teacherclass123@gmail.com and then my password. So let me log in with Google. It is not accepting that. So I'm using my Gmail ID. You can use your Gmail ID or Facebook ID. And once you log in, this will be the first dashboard which you will see here. So on the top, you see a create button where you can create quizzes for your learner. So once you click on the quiz button, it will ask you whether you want to subscribe or you want to try it for free. So let us try it for free. And there are various options where I can use the paid version also. So if I want to create a resource on the chapter agriculture, I will just type in my title, add a description, and three things which are important here to create flashcard is the term, because flashcard is all about the important terminology and vocabulary of the chapter. So I have to pay attention to the terminology, the definition, and the image which is going to make my flashcard attractive and my child gets some hint out of that. So this is what the flashcard is used for. So the important terms I want my child to remember from this chapter is, first is agriculture. So you will see the magic of this app is I just need to enter the term, and that app itself gives me the matching definition. by reducing my time to create a quiz. And also I can use the images which are given to me by the app itself, and my first flashcard is ready. Now I'm going to the second one. So the second important term from this chapter I want my child to remember is, what is viticulture? So the answer is already given by the app itself, thus reducing the time. Now the next term I want to make is the pisciculture. And let me see, yes, definition is given by the app itself. I have to see whether the image is there. Yes, it is giving me a good image also. Next term I want my child to know from this chapter is horticulture. Let me see if it has a term. Yes, it has, it in the image flashcard bank, and also the definition is there. Images, it has a lot of images also. I can pick accordingly. And once all my flashcards are ready, you can make up to 20, 50, howsoever you want to make, or you can import from the Word, Excel or Google Docs. So once it is done, I can simply click on create. And my study set will be ready. I can also add a class by putting the email IDs of the children, the way you do it in the Google Classroom. And the beauty of this particular tool is, you have just done the hard work once, but the app has automatically created your flashcard into different kind of challenge. The flashcard challenge will appear like a flashcard. The learn challenge will appear somewhat like some other type of quiz. You can see it has converted into a multiple choice questions. I can, my child can take it up as a write challenge. So in the writing challenge, the definition is there, the image is there, and they have to identify the term. So different kind of challenges are given to the children. You can convert it into a test, which can be downloaded also. You can print it also. And automatically the app has converted your questions into written question, multiple choice question, true false question. So this is the beauty of this app, that you only have to do a hard work once and your quiz will automatically be created into the multiple varieties which the child can take. And once your quiz is ready, you have to go to this share option, copy the link of the quiz and mail, or either put it on the Google Classroom, or you can copy it, send it through mail, copy and paste in the class WhatsApp group, copy in the email, and accordingly you can share the quiz with your learners. And you can also see there are other options. You can edit the quiz, you can add other questions to your quiz, you can view the class progress once the class has done the quiz, and also you have a live option once your quiz is ready. So I already have one study set which I have created for all of you to give you the experience of how the live quiz is played. So this is a teacher competency quiz. So you are also going to have a test right now. So once I open this quiz, I just have to click on the live option. And it is asking me, what do you want to do? You want to create a live game for your learners? So I will, yes, I will say create game. Again, it will ask me whether your learners are individual or they are doing it in teams. So every child is doing from his or her home. So I will click on individual. I will click on the combination of questions I want. So I will select it. And it is saying me that Quizlet live with music. You can also play the music and give an experience to your children where they can enjoy and dance along with you while taking the quiz. So here my children have to go to a website called www.quizletlive.live. So I request all the teacher participants to go to a website called www.quizlet.live and enter this game code. And the other option the app gives is, you can copy the game link and you can paste it in the chat window on whatever platform you are taking the classes. So right now we are on Zoom. So let me paste this link in the chat window. You can simply click on that link and join the game. So I have pasted the link. You simply click on this link and you will be added to my game. I am again showing you my screen, all those who want to participate from the website. So here I am.
Ma'am, can you paste the link on chat if you've not already?
Yeah, it's already pasted. I have already pasted in the chat window.
It's not showing, ma'am. Can you paste it again
and make
sure that it's sent or chatting to everyone?
Sure, ma'am. I will paste it again.
Yeah, or you can send it to me as well and I'll paste it. There, it's come. Someone, Monica, ma'am, thank you so much. So you can click on that link, teachers, and the PIN number is
472-084.
I'm pasting it again.
Yeah.
Okay, ma'am, you can share your screen.
Okay, thank you. Yes, I can see 43 players are already here with me in the game. Yes, come on, teachers, quickly, please join the quiz. Whatever experiences you are gathering today, the same kind of engaging and fun experience you have to give to your learners also. And that is our motto of taking this live session with all the teachers who are present here, who are sparing their very crucial time, I can say. As a teacher, I know how much of work we have to do after school, preparing for the lessons, thinking about the engagements that we have to do online. The virtual assemblies are going on. The virtual birthday celebrations are going on. Nothing has stopped, which we used to do as a teacher in the physical classroom. But we have to engage our learners to give them the most beautiful experiences of learning so that they should not be left behind. Every learner is important for us. And that is why these digital tools give you a platform where you can make learning fun for the learners, and they are never going to miss the class. I'm assuring you, because as a teacher, I'm myself using these tools at least once a week. After the chapter content is over, I plan a quiz on these platforms, and my children simply love these tools. And every time they ask me that, ma'am, when are you going to give the next test? So this is the spirit your children are going to have. So once all your players join, you simply have to click on this tab, create game. So right now I have 89 players. Let me create a game. And another beautiful thing this platform offers is that every person, every child or participant will be given a unique name of an animal or a bird. And you will be identified with different animals, species and bird species. So children enjoy this a lot. You can also play the option of music from here, and you can put the music on for your learners to enjoy. So let me start the game. So some of the people are not able to join, so I can start game anyway. And all your results are going to be displayed on my screen. Whatever answers you are giving, I will be able to see who is leading in the quiz. So you can start giving answers to the questions which are appearing on your screen. Here, the questions are not going to appear on my screen in this platform. The questions are going to be appearing on your screen.
Yeah.
ma'am, if you can reduce the volume.
Yes, ma'am, sure.
Ma'am, is there a way we can remove the sound effect?
Yes, ma'am, pardon.
Is there a way we can reduce the sound effects?
Yeah, sure. For that, maybe I need to
You can press the speaker button on your tab. No, on your tab, on your Chrome tab. Not that, ma'am. On your Chrome tab, where Quizlet ka tab, right? You can see the speaker.
Just a minute. Now it is fine?
Yeah.
Okay. So congratulations, Miss Deepa is the winner of this quiz. So very good, excellent. I'm very happy that you have all the teacher competency skills which are required. Great, ma'am. So once my game is over, I can click on the tab, exit. And this is how you can play the quiz. You have just created one flashcard, 5 to 6 flashcard. And you can give multiple experiences to your kids. You can do the matching activity where the definition is going to appear along with the different terminology that we have used. And the timer is running and I have to match the particular definition. And that app is going to tell me that how much marks I will get. And accordingly, the teacher is going to get the report of the child that what the child is doing, whether the child is able to do the quiz properly or not. So that is the beauty of the app which you will have in this particular tool, which is called Quizlet. So I simply have to match the particular term. So if I am doing a wrong one, it will say, tell me that you are not doing it correctly. So this is how I can give another gamified experiences to my kids. The leaderboard is showing that I have taken 30 seconds to complete this quiz and I can play it again. So this is how I can choose to do it again or play it again with my children. So are there any further questions, ma'am, on this particular app?
Quizlet? Yes, ma'am.
Yeah.
Yes, ma'am. I think someone's asking, is it possible on the phone to do matching by click and drag?
Yes. All these apps are, which I'm sharing today, all these are mobile friendly apps.
Okay.
And no such problem will come because as a parent, I also understand that maximum parents are doing work from home these days. And there are very limited devices at home. So as a teacher myself, if I have one laptop and I am using it, so my children are doing classes on mobile devices. So these apps are made in such a way that you can use it on any device, whether it is iPad or tab or maybe a laptop or desktop or mobile. So on every smart device, it is available.
Yeah.
And the same experience the child is going to enjoy.
Okay. And ma'am, we got a question on YouTube on our live stream saying that does Quizlet become a paid app after some time, or can you use it for free forever?
You can use it for free forever, but it will give you the prompts in between that please upgrade. But I can tell you, I'm using this app since January.
Okay.
And I have not subscribed yet. Every time I open it, it is I have just created a quiz in front of you. So it's been 6 months I'm using this app, and it is giving me the platform to create new quizzes. And also, if I don't want to make a quiz, I can go to the search tab and I can use the quizzes which are developed by the teacher across the world. Same like Kahoot, so I can click on the key term for which I am looking for the flashcards. And you can see here, there are a lot of flashcards which are developed by teachers across the world on agriculture. So this one has 68 terms, this one has 37 terms. So I can easily use all these flashcards and teach in my own class without paying to the app. All these are free to use tools. So maybe sometimes we are in a hurry, but we want to do something good for our children, but we don't have enough time. So we can utilize these resources which are developed by other teachers across the world. And you can see here all, or you can see the free ones. So the free sets are also available, the premium ones, the study guides, the users. You can sort it out with the different classes you want to. You can filter it out by finding an appropriate quiz with whatever class you are looking at, or most recent ones, most relevant ones. So this will reduce the lot of effort which the teachers have to make.
Okay. And ma'am, one question that's just come in is, do these live quizzes always need an email ID?
No.
Because
no.
I think the teacher was asked for email ID.
No, ma'am. When you as a student participate in the quiz, if the link which I shared with all of you in the chat window, you simply have to click on that link and automatically you will enter the quiz without asking for email ID.
All right. Yeah. And I think one of the key issues was that many people were not able to attempt the quiz, either because they were not able to see the questions, or I don't know what other issues.
Maybe, ma'am, that can be due to the internet connectivity, because all this is happening in the cloud. So sometimes it takes time to load the quiz, and it depends on whether we are using mobile data or Wi-Fi. So sometimes there is an internet connectivity issue, but you can again refresh your screen and try again.
Right.
Or you can mail the link to the children to play it later on if they are not able to play it in the live class.
All right. And ma'am, is it possible to create a math quiz through these through this platform or not?
Definitely you can prepare a quiz which does not involve mathematical equation, because this is a flashcard tool.
Right.
So the terms in mathematics, like what are whole numbers, prime numbers, composite numbers, rational numbers, or what are Roman numbers. So those terminology can be used in this particular tool, but not the questions. For that, we have another two tools that we are going to jump on. That is the quizzes and the Quizalis. Those two platforms, they offer the mathematical equations also.
All right. Okay, I think that's it for our questions. We can check whether teachers want to go to the next tool. So if, ma'am, what's the next tool? Quizzes, right?
Yeah, yeah. We are going to go to the next tool. So
If you all are excited to learn quizzes and you all want to take up quizzes, please type Q-U-I-Z-Z-I-Z in the chat so that we know you want to go ahead with the session.
Or you can also type in ready to learn. This is the hashtag which I have prepared. If I want to see if you are excited and you are still ready to learn and you are not tired. So I have more for everyone on the platform.
That's awesome. So many teachers are so excited to learn. Ma'am, I'll share my screen because I think there is some pixelation.
Yeah, sure, ma'am. For the PPT part, you can share. Okay.
Awesome.
Okay, ma'am. Next slide, please. So talking about quizzes.com, it is again an interface which engages everyone and anywhere you can engage your learner in different multiple ways by creating fun quizzes. And again, you need to go to the platform called Google and search for quizzes.com. Next slide, ma'am. So what is the quality or the different platform you are going to access through quizzes.com is You can find quizzes which interest you as per your subject expertise, or you can join a game in the live session. Just now you have seen how to join a live quiz through a game board, and these days children are very well familiar by playing games like Ludo King and Ludo Club, where the game team need to be shared. So similar way, the quizzes also offers this platform. Next slide, ma'am. So you can make a free account to create a quiz. You can generate the quiz reports, email the report to the students or parents, integrate with your LMS or the Google Classroom if you are using that. You can develop your own collection of quizzes by adding a particular quiz that you like made by the other teacher into your own collection. And also there is a very beautiful option of adding memes to be used while creating quizzes, which adds to the excitement of the learner. And after every question, as per their performance in that particular question, a meme is going to appear that really makes the learner happy. And I think this is the time when we also have to think about the social and emotional well-being of the child. So if by looking at that meme, a smile comes on your child's face, you are doing a great job, and you are thinking also about the mental well-being of the child rather than just thinking about the subject expertise. Next slide, ma'am. So this is the interface look like. Once I open it on the home page, you will see there is your profile pic. There are different multiple options on the left. The first one is you can find a quiz made by other teachers. You can make your own quizzes, which will be added to the My Quizzes tab. You have a report tab where you can download the reports of all the quizzes you have played. There is a tab called classes where you can add your own classroom by adding their email IDs. You can create a collection of quizzes which you like from other teachers and made your own collection class-wise, section-wise, or subject-wise. And you can also select what memes you want while creating your quiz. Next page, ma'am. And once you start creating a quiz, these are the few questions that you will get. You have to name the quiz. You have to choose the subject, relevant subject for which the quiz is to be made. Next, ma'am. So I think now we can go on to the demo session. So if you can stop sharing your screen, I can take the demo of this particular just to save time.
Yes, ma'am.
So let us go to the website quizzes.com. So once you type in Google quizzes, it will again ask you to log in, and this kind of window will appear in front of you. It will ask you whether you want to log in with your Gmail ID or you want to use any other email ID and the password. So it's always easy to log in with Gmail. And if you don't know how to make a Gmail ID or you don't have Gmail account, you can watch the YouTube tutorials by Sonia ma'am on Teacher Class platform website, where you will be taught how you can create your own Gmail account. So once you use your Gmail account, you will be entering a very interactive platform, which is called Quizzes. So you can see there is an option of finding a quiz, creating a new quiz. So if I don't have time to create a quiz, I can simply go to find a quiz. And for example, today I want to teach my children about poverty as a challenge. Since I'm a social science teacher, so I'm using all the social science topics. So there are different topics which I can see are created by the teachers across the world. This is a quiz for ninth grade, poverty as a challenge, which I can play live with my children. I can assign it as a homework, or I can do it as a solo practice also with my learners. So let me show you how you can create your own quiz using this platform. and especially for the maths teachers who were really curious about the maths equations. So this platform offers you that particular thing. So let me take you, create a new quiz. This is the tab you have to use. So it is asking me, name the quiz. So let us now make a quiz on Earth Day. And this is a geography quiz. I have to click on next button. Now, the good thing over here is that in Kahoot, there was a limitation of using only two type of questions, multiple choice and true false. But here, all the five types of question are free to use. I need not pay to the app. It does not ask for any kind of money to utilize all the features. So I can make multiple choice question. I can use checkbox question. I can use fill in the blanks. I can use poll. I can use open-ended question. So once I click on multiple choice question, so here there is an option of adding a maths equation. So I click here, add math equation. So this kind of calculator sort of thing will open from where I can insert a math equation also. And if I want to add an image or an audio, since my learners are quite young, they will not be able to read out the question. I can make a quiz using the images or using the my own audio voice also. So since I am typing the question here and my quiz is on Earth Day. So my first question is, more than half of oxygen comes from, so I have to give the options to my children. So I'm saying whether it comes from forest or it comes from the oceans or does it come from the flowering plants or it comes from the clouds. And whichever option is correct, I have to give the correct answer so that when my children are playing the quiz, they are aware that yes, their answer is correct. So I can add maths equation as an option also, you can see here. Or I also have the option of adding images to my quiz instead of the text. So there is only one option here. In Kahoot, you had both the options. Text also, image also, but here you can only either put a text or a image to your question, and I can also have the option of timer. So as per the difficulty level of the question, I can set the timings of the question also. So you can see up to 15 minutes, I have the timer for each question, and once my question is set, I can click on save button. So this is my first question. And adding new question, I just have to use a new question tab, or maybe you want to use the question bank, which is developed by the quizzes only. So I have to use this other option, teleport. So once I go to teleport, I can see there are a lot of other quizzes which are already prepared by the teacher related to Earth Day. So I can use this question. Yes, this question is gelling with my quiz. So I have already used it, and I can scroll down and use more questions which are created by the teachers around the world. So there are so many questions which I can use. I can simply click on add and use the questions which are created by the teacher. So once my questions are set, I can simply come and preview my questions once more, whether the timing is set or not. And I can add an image to my quiz. I can drag and drop an image or paste an image link from Google. I just have to select the language and the grade for which the quiz is made. So I say it is for class 9th. Do you want your quiz to be public or to be used by other teachers, or you want it to be private? and you click on save button. So your quiz is ready to be shared with your students. So once you click on done button, it will appear like it, like this. You can play it live. You can assign it as homework. So if I assign it as homework, I can put in the date by when my child is supposed to complete this quiz along with the timer. I can add and continue. So once I click on continue, this is the link I have to share with my children to play this quiz. I just have to click here and the link will be copied, and that can be pasted in any of the platform, either in the Gmail or your Facebook account or your WhatsApp class account, or you can also ask your participants to go to a platform called joinmyquiz.com and enter this code 656-6644. So this is how you can explain it. Yes, ma'am.
I think you're not audible, so we'll just take a 5-second pause.
Okay, ma'am.
In the meanwhile, teachers requesting you to register with us. I see a lot of teachers asking for the website. So Sumedha ma'am is also going to be creating a Padlet of resources for this session. And what we will do is we'll attach the presentation as well as the Padlet into an email that all of the participants will receive. So you will get access to the presentation and Padlet. It has all the resources. All right. Ma'am, someone had a question. Have you finished your demo, ma'am? Or do you want to show more?
Yeah, I wanted to show more. Am I audible?
Yes, now you're audible. I think participants are finding that you are audible now.
Okay, ma'am. Okay. So let me continue. So once your quiz is ready and you have created the quiz, you can play it live, or you can assign it as a homework, or assign it as a practice test for your learners to do it later on. And then in the report section, I can show you that whatever quizzes you have played, you can download the reports as an Excel file from here. And also there is an option while you are playing a live quiz. At the end of the live quiz, it asks you if you want to give that particular data to the parents. So it will ask for the email IDs of the parent, and that can be mailed to the parents later on. So this is the quiz I played with my participants on one of the projects which Modi ji is running, that is the Namami Gange. And this is how the result is being reflected in the reports. And that can be mailed to the parents from here of each child. How much score is there? What is the accuracy of the quiz? So this is how this platform is an amazing platform which you can utilize. So I can show you how you have to play a live quiz with your learners. So let us try this quiz only, which is on the Namami Gange. So I just have to click on live play, classic mode, because you all are doing it from your own mobile devices. And children have to go to a website called joinmyquiz.com and enter this game code. Or this link can also be shared via link. I can copy the link from here and I can paste the link in the chat window in whichever platform I am teaching my students. So right now I'm pasting this link in the chat window, and I request all the dear teachers to please join the quiz through that link, quizzes.com, and the ID is 189699. Let me see how many participants are there. So yes, I can see two participants have already joined. Great, four participants, five. I request all the participants to join the quiz to take the flavor that how this is going to be enjoyed by the students. Once you experience the particular tool, then only you will be able to use that tool for your students. Until and unless you experience the tool, it will be difficult for you to explain the student and the other teacher community that why this tool is beneficial and how does it make a difference to your teaching. So I can see 18 teachers have already joined. Excellent. 20. Very nice. I'm so happy to see your excitement towards learning new EdTech tools. Great. Awesome. Wow. I have 35 players with me. Excellent. Okay, so I have almost 50 participants now, and let me start the quiz quickly. Next 10 seconds more, I am waiting for all of you to join. Okay, let us start the quiz.
Participants are answering the questions. We can also see the ranking of the participants.
Yes, ma'am. On my screen, the ranking is visible.
All right.
Yeah. Is it visible to you on my screen?
Yes, we can see.
Yeah, that. Yes. Enjoyed the game. So let me see who are the winners. I hope by now everyone must have completed the quiz. So on my podium, the third position goes to Miss Gaz, first position goes to Miss Shweta, and the second one to Mr. or Miss SB. And this is how the platform gives me the overview of each and every question. What is your score in percentage? I can email this particular report to Shweta's parents by putting up the email ID. I can see how much time was taken. I can review the questions. I can play it again. So this is how this platform converts the entire learning experience into a gamified experience and also caters to the mental well-being of the student by giving them a fun kind of thing where while seeing the memes, there is a smile on each child's face. And that is the more important criteria in the lockdown period. We have to first cater to the emotional well-being of our learners rather than thinking about the cognitive well-being. So this is how this platform is an excellent tool which all the teachers must use it. You can create your own quizzes, you can find a quiz, you can check the reports, you can make your collections.
Ma'am, you're not audible. It's not loud enough.
Let me just connect again. Is this fine now?
Yes. Yes.
Okay. So if you are having any questions about this quizzes tool, you can ask me or we can proceed.
Yes, ma'am. So I think,
are there any questions, ma'am, for this particular tool?
Yes, ma'am, there are questions. So I think one of the questions that teachers did share is that, I'm just looking for the questions. Actually, no one has put in questions for this session. We've asked for some repetitions of certain parts of what you did. So I think like one thing I'd like to suggest is we're streaming this live on YouTube. So it will be available on our YouTube channel. So you can watch or re-watch that session. And yes, teachers, you can type a question in Hindi if you have a question in Hindi. Please use this. No, there are some. Oh, that was a question. So one teacher asked whether on quizzes, can they type questions in Hindi?
I think you have the option of Hindi language on the Kahoot. But I have not explored the Hindi language option on quizzes, since most of the quizzes I have made, it is in English language only. But we can always go to the find a quiz option and check it out there for the teachers.
Yeah. One teacher is offering that Kahoot is a good option for Hindi. So if you have any Hindi questions, Kahoot can make a...
Kahoot offers the other language options also.
Right. And I think someone asked, is it possible to take quizzes for math classes as well?
Yes, ma'am. I showed you that there is a math equation option.
Right. If you could just show
that.
There is
a math equation.
Yeah, I think the teacher missed that. So they've asked this question.
Okay, sure. I will show it again. So I was just checking if there are some quizzes based on Hindi. So if you go to create a quiz option, first you have to name your quiz. And once you name it, second thing is you have to select the subject it is catering to. Click on the next button and it will show you different kind of questions that you can use. So here is the option of adding a math equation. This
all right
on the right hand side. If I click here, so this calculator kind of advanced calculator sort of thing will open up where I can insert a math equation.
Awesome.
Yeah.
Awesome. Great. Yes. I think, ma'am, most teachers, we've communicated that the session will only be till 5 o'clock, and most teachers have some other commitments. So what I would like to do is release our last poll. Teachers, please stay for 10 more seconds and just answer this last poll that I am launching and let us know how comfortable are you feeling right now with online assessment tools and how would you rate this session? This feedback is going to be very, very useful for us as we design other live classes. We will be, what we are going to do is we will break this session into two parts, all right? And we will do the other two tools, right? Ma'am, we finished three tools, only two tools are left. right? We'll do those two tools next week instead of doing Bansi. So if you want to register for that live class, I request all teachers to fill this form that I'm going to share with you and register for our live class next week. I know there were a few teachers who are saying that I registered for this class only for Padlet and we're not able to do Padlet. What I can do is I will share the link for Padlet. Maybe Zainab ma'am, you can try Padlet on your own and register for the class next week. We can take questions and so forth. All right. So requesting all teachers to sign up for the class on Friday next week, that is 17th July. And we will do this repeat session. Requesting all teachers to please participate in our poll and tell us how comfortable, how confident you're feeling using assessment tools and how would you rate this session? Awesome. I'm going to end poll and I'm going to share our results. Thank you, Namrata ma'am, for your suggestion, something like some sort of tools that will help with subjective type questions. So we'll take it up. We'll be doing one class at least a week if Sumedha ma'am has time with her every week, exploring newer and newer tools. Sumedha ma'am has learned up to 20 plus tools using technology. So we're going to do these sessions either on Tuesdays or Fridays. So please save the link to our registration. And I'm sharing that link again. And make sure that you keep checking back the same link and registering for a live class of your choice. All right. So please save that link that I just pasted in the chat. And make sure you keep checking that link every time you want to join a class. Our classes will be held through the week at 3 p.m. The timing is the same. All right. So I'm going to stop sharing the screen. It's great that teachers are feeling a little bit more familiar with online assessment tools. Kudos to you, Sumedha ma'am. You've done a great job. Everyone is thanking you in the comment section for being so patient and explaining it so well. We're really happy. Yeah, we're really happy, that teachers are finding these sessions useful.
Thank you so much, ma'am, for the platform. I'm extremely happy to see the lot of overwhelming response from all the teachers and the kind of interaction they were doing, the questions they were posting. It itself is a testimony of their involvement in the session. In the evening where everyone is waiting for the teachers to serve tea.